the only way the Bible says we are to open the gate of heaven is through your giving.
Right.
It's through your giving, and it's very, very simple. It's the financial plan right here. It's very simple. Give God what it belongs to God from the get-go. And then, not only what it belongs to God, always belong to God, but give what comes out of your heart, that means your offering. And a lot of us, what comes out of our heart is always a dollar. So if you are working and you didn't know about, you know, I'm talking about teenagers, you never heard about tithes, well, you heard it now. If you are working and you get paid, that should be the first thing that comes out is your tithe, because that's the only way that the work of the Lord operates. It's the only way. It's not by selling chicken plates every weekend. We can sell chicken plates and all kind of food every weekend. It's not going to work.
Right.
Why? Because you go spend the money on the chicken, you come home, cook the chicken, run up the smart bill, then you go back and buy the same chicken that you bought to begin with. So how is that going to work? It's not going to work. It's never going to work, because I want people count on chicken plate thinking they're going to run the church with that. It's not going to work. You buy this chicken five times already, you're paying for this same chicken. Start from the store, come cook, go back over there where you have it, and buy it again. It makes no sense. But some more people think, you know, that's the way you run the church. It doesn't do that. No way. And then, this is a very important right here, and I'm going to finish. I will prevent pests, the insects that we're going to talk about here, like insects or wild things, from devouring your crops. What it says right here, because in the old days, people bring in their tithes with the crops. You know, the fruit of your produce and all that. This is in the old days. But God said, you do that and I will prevent the, you know, the pest from eating up your crops. Well, we don't use crops over here no more, we use money.
Right.
And you know the problem, the pest I'm talking about, have you ever had a break $100? You broke $100 and then a few minutes later, a couple hours later, you know, you try to figure out what happened to the rest of the change. So that's, you know, we don't have produce no more, but that's the best that eats up your money. You bring $100, you put 20 in the gas, and then you find out you don't know where the other 80 bucks went. So that's the best that's eating up your paycheck. You don't know because you don't pay your tax. Simple as that. All of a sudden you don't know where the rest of the money go. I remember years ago, you know, you spend your money, your paycheck, and then you don't know. But by the time you get home, you don't know what happened to your whole check. But I, you know, those days when, you know, people drink and all that. But that's the best they're talking about here. I would prevent the pest from devouring your crops. And the vines in the field will not cast their fruits. So if you don't pay your tithes, all these things are gonna, it's almost like a curse. So that's pretty much our lesson is. Now we're gonna go to is there what no pan over here or
we're here.
So much out of busy.